being an automotive shop, we do alignments. So we didn't feel like spending the $30,000-$40,000 on a laser alignment. That, and realistically, laser alignments aren't the best option. We went with Quick Trick, which is a string alignment kit. We have a video where we did everything like setup and all the other stuff with it. This is actually a really good kit if you use it like 3 times a year. Using it 3 times in a day, it is super annoying to set up. It takes a long time. There is no time efficiency with it. Granted, in the past almost year, I think, that we've had this setup, we've had many customers say that they've gotten the best alignment they've ever felt from what we did, which I can only thank this system for. So in the time that we've had it, we decided we need to make this easier to put on because time is money, right? And so these are normal heads for an alignment setup, right? They have these little pieces here. They flip so you can have two different size or style ends. They clamp on the wheel in 4 spots, where this one clamps on the wheel in 3 spots. 3 spots, triangles, you know, strongest shape in the world, whatever, that kind of crap. Not the greatest, especially when trying to grab onto a circular surface. So we'd have problems with them twisting. The other thing too is you can see these holes here. So these holes are there because these two pieces were held together by a twist nut, right? So it would screw in and it would hold it together. That is nice, and I know why they did it, because they did it so that you could fold this up and put it in your trunk and then do an alignment at the racetrack. Not angry about it, just, like I said, 3 times in a day, it moves. It's really annoying. What I decided to do was mount these to the heads, drilled some holes, mounted them to the heads, they screwed on. I welded these because I didn't want this to be able to move separate of this. Now, since I'm a welder, not an engineer, I didn't take into consideration these warping because they are thin aluminum. So they did warp, which means that this is now, it's not straight, which affects the alignment, and we can't have that if we want it to be good. So what I decided to do was essentially we're going to throw away the Quick Trick stuff, but I'm going to mimic their design with steel. I have what's going to be a base and what's going to be the upright. And so this is going to mimic this. And since we don't need this actual piece to grab onto the wheel, it doesn't have to be this tall. So it's just going to go on there like that. I'm going to be drilling some holes. I'm going to be putting some holes to keep the tape, or the, what's it called? The rulers here. Because the rulers are how you get your alignment. But everything needs to be straight for your alignment to be good. So I'm going to sit here and drill this, and then we're going to try to mimic the Quick Trick stuff as best as we can, because it works amazing. I want it to be better. Ingenuity is where it starts. So I got this one together, and it does look a little different, but it should match really well. These came out really good, which these are the alignment things, and it's got these little notches that you put the string on, and that's how you line up with the front or back, matching these up with it. We're only going to do the front and back for welding them together. That's more than enough for doing string alignments. It doesn't really need much more than that. I do have 3 more of these to make. But after doing this, compared to this one, I grabbed the straight edge and laid it on the 3 faces that have nothing, you know, welded to it, and it is perfectly flat. I set this on the table, which we've already straight edged the table, and that's perfectly flat. And these, the base of this to the table was 7 7/32 seconds. Of a gap on either end, which tells me that it is perfectly straight there, which means when we put it on the car, there should be absolutely nothing that makes it, you know, a wonky alignment, or it says it's straight, but it's actually off, which these ones have that. They're a little off. I'm going to go grab the straight edge so I can show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so this one across the bottom here, we have the straight edge, and I know it's a little different on the camera, but it's just straight, right? Come over here. We're going to match this side up with it. And that's what we got over there. So, yeah, you shouldn't be able to see my finger on the other side if we're trying to go with straight. And that's what we were trying to fix, because that's going to affect the alignment no matter what. My best guess is it's because I welded it. Aluminum flexes and all that stuff. Steel, I can weld those together at a low enough temperature that it doesn't affect the straightness of its edge, which is what we need. I'm gonna go get the other ones done. These heads we got off of Amazon. There's a bunch of places that make them. I just wasn't 100% sure if this was going to work, so I went with a inexpensive option for now. But in the future, we'll probably opt for a nicer set, or I might make a, we're joking, this is version 3 of my alignment setup, so we might do a version 4, or maybe a 3.2 or something.
I've got all of them together, and we're gonna actually redo Steve's car because his was aligned with V2. And as we know, V2 did not go over very well. So V1 was great, V2 sucked balls. We're gonna make sure that this is good with V3.
Is it the typical order to lower it down, let the wheels spread out, and then put the brake pedal depressor on it? That's what I normally do.
To see how easy these go on versus the before. And then the last thing is to actually set these level. Last thing on this side is the string.
I never leveled that.
I did.
So then since Steve's car is a squared wheelbase, we're gonna do 3 in the front and 3 in the back.
We got this because of other learned things. They have the steering wheel like brace or whatever that goes on the bottom of a steering wheel and supposed to keep it from turning, where this is just a level that you set in the steering wheel, and I find this to be a lot better than the other option. All right, so we've got a little bit of toe out on this side, which would definitely be why his steering wheel is off to the right.
Thing too is because these are actually sturdy and whatnot and other things like that, I haven't been putting the string very tight.
Yeah.
I put it on.
Oh, we gotta go down with the lift more.
Oh my god.
With the old version, the size wheels that it allows is, I think, 13 to 20 inch wheels, which is a pretty good range. These, however, because they have the 3 steps of where you can put the little arms, they'll do anywhere from 11 to 25 inch wheels. So definitely that will help us out as well.
A little bit more. And a little tiny bit.
Okay.
Oop. A little bit less.
Okay.
So setup time, like putting the heads on, how long it took us to do all four of them was probably still faster than doing one before. Because the big thing with them was, you see these,
how we've got them like slid on and they're against the face of the wheel and all that other stuff. Most of the time with how the old ones were, or the originals, it's really hard to get it 100% shoved in there because of the tire. And since all you're doing is snugging it in its position, it doesn't like grab into, like further into where this one does. When you squeeze everything down with the cog up here, it'll pull it towards the face of the wheel, which makes sure that it's as straight with the face of the wheel as it possibly can be. With the other one, it would move here and there, or, you know, it would slide on the wheel, or it would have movements that just don't help the alignment be quick.
This one's got to go out.
Less than three.
Yeah, yeah. This one's got to go out a little bit.
Now, wrong way. Okay.
So you always want a tiny bit of toe-in in the front because it helps track the car straight.
Tiny bit of toe-in in the rear is okay. Zero toe in the rear is also okay. You don't want toe out because then the car's going to try to walk away from you as you drive straight.
We're now done with the alignment.
Everything looks great. Everything is where we want it. So the only next test is we're going to send Steve to go drive his car and tell us how good or bad it is. But I will say, it probably took us, I'm not going to tell you exactly how long because I'm still going to charge the same amount. But it probably took us a third or a quarter of the time to do the alignment this time than we used to take with the old setup, or V1. V2 got two uses, and then we said, screw this, it ain't working.
Steve got back from his test drive after us doing the alignment, and in his own words, he said this is the best alignment he's ever, I'm just kidding. He said it was straight, it drove straight, it didn't have any pulls any direction, which when we had it with V2, he said it had a slight pull to the right, but it wasn't bad. Now, it is just driving straight, feels smooth, there's no wishy-washy on roads or whatever. It just felt like he was driving a car, which is literally all you need after an alignment. So I would say that this is a success. No, I don't know where you can buy this because I made it. But if you like what we're doing here, like the channel, follow us, subscribe, do all that nonsense. We do have the video of us doing the first alignment with V2, and then we have the other video of us doing it with the actual Quick Trick setup, which is still a good setup. So if you're going to buy this for like yourself and you're going to use it every once in a while, the Quick Trick is so much easier than doing all of this. But check out our other videos. We've got some more coming. We're probably going to be doing some suspension upgrades to that Civic, so it's going to need another alignment. But thanks for watching.